everyone. I'm here to talk about the most electrifying force known to humankind, the power of ideas. And I'm talking about that, it's not about light bulbs or eureka moments. I'm talking about what's transforming the world one aha at a time. When I was asked to present this topic, I looked up a lot of things online. I was trying to find YouTube videos, but then I went to our new best friend, ChatGPT. It gave me the most logical flow, but it wasn't real. It wasn't human, it wasn't me. Then I realized I was looking at the wrong AI. I needed to tap into my own AI. And by that, I mean awareness intelligence. As opposed to intellectual intelligence, I'm talking about the intelligence that comes from within us. But a million-dollar question is, how do we access that? By being present. Presence refers to a state of being fully aware and being engaged in the current moment. In our normal lives, we are so occupied with our thoughts, whatever is going on in our minds. By being aware or being present, I mean you are attentive to what's going on around you and within you. Establishing presence means you're not preoccupied with your thoughts about the past or the future. Don't worry, I'm not here to recruit you in a tribe, in this uniform especially. I'm here to just talk about the benefits. And I'm not discerning the fact that mind is not a powerful tool. It is. But mind can be used as a powerful tool to co-create consciously. Our ideas have the power to change lives and to create consciously. A famous author, Eckhart Tolle, once mentioned in his book, The Power of Now, that our mind cannot focus on breathing and thinking at the same time. By placing your attention on your breath, you're essentially creating a break in your continuous thoughts and creating stillness and presence within you. I want us to take a minute and do this exercise with me. There are no abductions happening, no aliens that I know of. I'd love for you guys to close your eyes for a second, or a minute, not for a second, and I'll help you breathe for a minute consciously with me. Please close your eyes. Breathe in, count of four. One, two, three, four. Hold it for four. One, two, three, four. Breathe out for four. One, two, three, four. You can open your eyes. Thank you so much for doing this with me. I hope you felt the presence, some kind of consciousness or awareness inside of you. Just remember that even if it's for a minute, you're connecting with your intuition by doing this exercise. And for thousands of years, people have practiced mindful breathing to get in touch with their inner self. And this is how you become very attuned to your inner guidance. Just be patient and trust the process. We often get our ideas, you know, in random places. For me, at least, I get it in the shower, while I'm driving, or, you know, even when I'm cleaning. J.K. Rowling once said that the idea of Harry Potter came to her during her train journey. She described it as a strong intuition, and then she spent years developing the story. Albert Einstein also said, the only real valuable thing is intuition. The intellect has very little to do on the road of discovery. There comes a leap in consciousness, call it intuition, or whatever you want to call it. The solution just comes to you, and you don't even know how or why. To be honest, not every idea is a good idea, and we all know that. But how can you tell if the idea is good and it can change people's lives? Well, one thing is for sure. If it's coming from a sense of self-fulfillment, it's not the right way. Instead of traditional way of thinking, like how am I going to make money or what the ROI is going to be, start thinking how you can make a difference. This leads to the story of my life. In my own life, the power of being in the now became an important part of my entrepreneurial journey. Back in 2015, when I was living in New York, I was walking down the streets of New York City, and something occurred to me that I'd never seen before, or rather I'd never noticed before. All runway models and fashion magazines had stereotypical bodies. Instagram had gained its popularity through filters on its images. When I came home, I sat down, I sat with the idea, and I let my intuition guide me. And that's what came next. It became my personal mission to promote body positivity and self-love. I'd never even heard about the hashtag body positivity, self-love before. I knew what that meant, but I didn't know the popularity of it. I let my creativity flow through me without doing any external research. But of course, before launching the company, I did the SWOT analysis, but I knew that I was going in the right direction. To launch my first company, my friend and I launched a campaign right in front of New York Fashion Week. We stood there with a board that said, you don't have to be a model in real life. It was called the Be Real campaign, where visitors to the show and people around the street would come and put a sticker on a plus-size model and a transgender model if they resonated with our idea. We had thousands of people who came. We got a lot of PR. Our YouTube video had 100,000 hits on a single day. That was a sign for me. My intuition was right, and my idea was going to change lives. Long story short, here I am. I have a fashion tech startup that uses AI, using my AI to create an AI that styles women for their body shapes. It all started with one idea and my practice of being present. I've often been asked, what are the best practices to stay present in your daily life? Meditation is key. I often do that with my team. I meditate myself. Setting up your daily goal for like 30 minutes of meditation can make you feel great. But here's the thing. If you meditate for 30 minutes and you feel great, but you spend the rest of your day being completely unaware of your internal environment, your thoughts, your feelings, then it's like eating organic food for breakfast and then McDonald's for the rest of the day. So by being present, I just don't mean that you have to sit there and meditate all the time. It also means you're fully engaging in the external and internal environment. This is like paying close attention to everything that's going around you, situations, people, experiences, around us and within us. Through careful observation, we may notice that there are patterns, there are opportunities, there are needs that can spark innovative ideas. Studies have shown that MRI can show that there's the high activity in your brain when you're sitting in a mindful state, like in a meditation, and you become very creative at that point. Trust me, I'm not 100% present at all times of my life. I'm work in progress, but I know the benefits, and that's what I'm sharing with you today. Life has been a journey to learn and grow, and I'm not a monk. Even after a decade of my own practice, this past summer, everything fell through. I was lost. I was looking for answers everywhere. I was looking for answers on Instagram tarot card readings. But then I came back to my basics. I switched off my social media. I made small changes in my daily routine. Besides meditation, I started reading more. I started playing sports. I used my willpower to stay present in every situation. 3 months down the road, I now have two more fashion startups that I've launched. Not all my ideas were 100% successful, but I love the journey so far. So here I am to tell you, embrace the transformative potential of presence and mindfulness in your creative journey. I ask you to follow your heart, tap into that boundless willpower of yours, put in 100% effort to transform lives, and just remember to use your AI, your awareness intelligence. Thank you.